Imam Abu Hanifa rahimahullahu ta'ala was not only a great faqih, he was a very great muhaddis too. Imam Adam, the great Imam, the great Imam, Sirajul A'imma, the lantern of the Imams. He was a very great faqih, but he was also a very great muhaddith. A person cannot become a jurist, a faqih, without being a master in the field of tafsir and the field of hadith. Because it is from the Quran and from the ahadith, the masail are deduced. So it is not possible for a person to become a faqih without being a master in the Quran, in the tafsir of the Quran, and in the science of ahadith. And Imam Abu Hanifa rahimahullahu ta'ala is acknowledged as the greatest faqih. Al-Imam al-Azam, the great Imam. If he was the great Imam and the greatest faqih, then definitely he had great insight in the science of tafsir and also the science of hadith. Otherwise, he could not have become a great faqih. Imam Shafi rahimahullahu ta'ala, he says, "An-nasu 'iyalun ala Abi Hanifata fil fiqh." If you put all the fuqaha together, including himself, Imam Shafi rahmatullahi alayhi says, if you put all the fuqaha together, then Imam Abu Hanifa rahmatullahi alayhi is the father and all the other fuqaha are his children. Great Imam. So he was a muhaddis too. There is a book of hadith compiled by Imam Bukhari rahimahullahu ta'ala, which is known as Sahihul Bukhari in short. Al-Jami, Al-Musnad, Al-Mukhtasar, Al-Sahih. This is the long name of Bukhari. In short, Sahihul Bukhari. This is the book compiled by Imam Bukhari rahimahullahu ta'ala. Sahih Muslim, book of hadith compiled by Imam Muslim rahimahullahu ta'ala. Muwatta Imam Malik, book of hadith compiled by Imam Malik rahimahullahu ta'ala. Imam Nasai rahimahullahu ta'ala. Sunanun Nasai, Tirmidhi Sharif, Sunanut Tirmidhi. Ibn Majah, Sunan Ibn Majah. Abu Dawud, Sunan Abi Dawud. There were so many muhaddisin who collected the ahadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam, and the whole ummah is indebted to them. The whole ummah is indebted to them. The ummah is indebted to the Huffaz for preserving the Quran. The ummah is indebted to the Qurra for preserving the correct intonation of the Quran. The ummah is indebted to the mufassirin for safeguarding the commentary of the Quran. The ummah is indebted to the muhaddithin for safeguarding the ahadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wa alihi wasallam. And the ummah is also indebted to the fuqaha for deducing the masail which were lying hidden in the oceans of Quran and ahadith. and making the deen very easy for the ummah. We are busy people. I can use two words. We are lazy and we are busy. But lazy is a bit disrespectful. So giving benefit of doubt to everybody, we are busy people. I am lazy, everybody else is busy. Lazy, busy. We cannot even find time to read a booklet. 15 pages, 20 pages, 30 pages. Never mind a booklet, we cannot find time to read a leaflet. Two sides of A4. No time. We have no time to take out 2 minutes and stand near the notice board and read one hadith, one mas'ala, one advice, anecdote of a pious personality. So if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had left it to you and me to study the Quran, study the tafsir, study the ahadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam and try to find guidance and deduce rulings and masails pertaining to our day-to-day life, how would it have been possible for us to practice the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? So all these great personalities, we are indebted to them. The muhaddisun, the mufassirun, the fuqaha, the qurra, the huffaz. So Imam Abu Hanifa rahimahullah ta'ala has his compilation also. Musnadul Imam Abi Hanifa. The Musnad of Imam Abu Hanifa rahimahullah ta'ala, a book of hadith. Musnad of Imam Abu Hanifa rahimahullah ta'ala. If he was not a muhaddis, why is it that this book is sold in the market, in the Arab world, non-Arab world? Where did this book come from? Musnadul Imam Abi Hanifa. If he was not a muhaddis. So Imam Abu Hanifa rahimahullah ta'ala was a great faqih, jurist. Very great faqih. A great muhaddis and a very, very, very pious personality. Very pious personality. He would engage in teaching and learning and worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala throughout 24 hours. And he would only give his body rest at the time of Qailula for half an hour or hour. The remaining 23 hours, worship and service to ilm. And for 40 years, it is recorded that for 40 years, he performed his Fajr Salat with the wudu of his Isha Salat. Not that he performed his Isha Salat and thereafter he engaged in futile activities and he did not sleep. And he was able to retain his wudu because he would not sleep at night. And he performed his Fajr Salat with the same wudu, no. What this means is that he performed Isha Salat and thereafter he engaged himself in ibadah until the Fajr Salat. And he performed his Fajr Salat with the wudu of the Isha Salat. So a comprehensive personality, a very great personality.